remembrance for the killing of the Carpathian Germans, Slovaks and Hungarians after the Second World War. Article by János Kőkés, June 21, 2017. On Sunday, June 18, in central Moravian city of Perov, commemoration day was held for the tragically massacred Carpathian Germans, Slovaks and Hungarians, one of the greatest tragedies of Czechoslovakia after the Second World War, on June 18, 1945 in Perov, the Czech media reported. According to historians' researches, Czechoslovak soldiers killed more than 260 innocent civilians in the so-called Swedish ditch in the hillside near the town. This Swedish ditch has nothing to do with Sweden. An investigation of the tragedy was ordered by a court judgment after the war, but after the communist takeover in 1948, it was finally concealed. For a decade, the monstrous event was hardly spoken, written, or was misunderstood, and factually and objectively only after 1989 the wider public was aware of it. During the commemoration, besides the Swedish ditch, the remains of over 200 victims were reburied in the mass grave for the first time at the end of May this year. The mass graves of men were discovered at the Swedish ditch, and the remains of bones found there were placed in Perovi city burial ground. The scene of the tragedy was marked with a plaque in 2015. Last year, at the burial ground in Olmutz, the remains of nearly 200 women and children were found. Their remains were also removed and placed next to the men in the Perovi burial ground. The truth came to light, and we have to respect it, said Vladimir Puchalski, mayor of the city, on the act of killing dozens of people. Representatives of the village of Dobšina in Slovakia also participated in the commemoration. About half of the victims came from Dobšin. According to our people, this was the great tragedy which happened at the end when the war was over. I think it is good to remember these sad things, which are supposed to be a warning to the young generation of today that nothing like this should ever happen, said Anna Klaus-Manova, mayor of Dobšin, after the commemoration, talking to the journalists. Since the regime changed, a remembrance was held every year in the local church in Dobšinovo, also a memorial plaque reminds us of the victims. The majority of the victims were German nationals, but there were many Slovaks and Hungarians among them, said Dr. Harmata Tibor, chairman of the German Alliance of German Carpathians. He stated that after the Second World War, the Czechoslovak authorities claimed that at the time only fascist German soldiers and members of the notorious SS detachment were executed in Perov. This is the reason why only the bodies of men were left in the pit of the spot, while the women and children were kept secretly in the burial ground of in Olmutz, said Harmata. Descendants and relatives of the victims still live in Dobšina today, he added. The event known as the Perovi massacre happened a few weeks after the end of World War II, on June 18, 1945, during the night. At Perovi railway station, there were accidentally two trains, a civilian and a military. The civilian train was transporting home the Carpathian Germans deployed to the countryside, according to the available sources, which arrived at the Perovi railway station on June 18, where they were stopped, giving way to other important transports. This was normal at the post-war situation. Nearby was a previously stationed train transporting back the soldiers of the 17th Czechoslovak Infantry Military from Prague to Slovakia, where they allegedly participated in a parade. several Czechoslovak soldiers from Dobšiná and Pilse have noticed that the civilians on the other train were people from their area and engaged in a conversation with them. The news came to Karol Pazur, the commander of the infantry. Pazur, with a dubious past, immediately exploited the situation for himself. He claimed that the civil Germans were actually Nazis, warriors, and therefore they should be punished. According to Czech historians, there is no clear evidence that the civilians were found guilty of any wrongdoing. The fact is, however, that the whole action was led by Karol Pazur with the effective involvement in Berič Smetana, the Politburo of the infantry regiment. The soldiers took the civilian at night to the Swedish ditch, where they were executed without a trial and thrown in a huge freshly dug pit. Czech historians have found out that among the victims there were 120 women, 72 men and 75 children. The exact ethnic composition of the victims could not be determined 100% afterwards. Most of them were German, but some victims were Slovaks and Hungarians. This is based on the memories of the inhabitants of Dobšiná and other villagers from the area. Only a few people from Dobšiná survived. The Czechoslovak soldiers deprived their victims of their valuables and the train was robbed. Karol Pazur was sentenced to 7.5 years imprisonment for the first time, then the highest military court in Prague in 1949 sentenced him for 20 years imprisonment. He spent about a year in jail when Clement Gottwald, the Czechoslovakian head of state, at the time announced a general amnesty and Karol Pazur was released from prison. There is no written evidence, but according to those who dealt with the case, Pazur's liberation had a lot to do with his ties to the contemporary influential communist leaders. František Hybl, a historian who has been studying for many years the background of the tragedy, believes that Karol Pazur had a very dubious past. His criminal act explains that he wanted to earn merit in the eyes of the newly formed communist power. The historian also discovered that Karol Pazur was originally called Karol Kohn. In the background of the events, it was not the punishment of the alleged Nazis, but personal motives.